Yo.
Yo, how it do?
Oh,
Whose internet
it's
it will
good.
go up today?
Sneaky's actually over at my house streaming on Eunice's computer.
Are you serious?
Yeah, his internet was still out today. Wait, and TSM's fucking role swapping. All right, well, we're starting off with a fucking
Is it
banger.
because this match doesn't matter for either team?
I think so, yeah. Dude, I've honestly been curious what double jungle would look like if a team can pull that off. Because it's just like, think about it. You
You
just,
could
both junglers.
potentially starve one lane from being ever able to play the game.
Well, I mean,
Like you
dude.
could.
Yeah. So the way I thought about it was, it's just like, you're basically, both junglers just take one quadrant, right? Like, take three camps, and then you just start laning with the other guy. All right.
Looks like we're off to a good start in LCS. So this is actually against the rules. I'm like 90% sure. Like intentionally trolling the game is against the rules. Putting in your academy team, like putting in a like suboptimal roster is not against the rules. Picking troll picks, not against the rules. Running it down mid is definitely against the rules. I was for sure clarified about this. Like, you guys can lock in Glacial Comp. Like, you can do the trollest draft ever where you pick five shit champs. But if you go into game and you're obviously griefing, that's against the rules. That's what I remember Riot telling me. Maybe the rules changed though. I could be wrong about whatever the fucking rule book is now.
Yeah.
EU this morning actually ran it too. Oh my god.
Huh. Hold up. I think Sneaky said there's some audio issue with the computer. I'm gonna go try to help him fix it. BRB.
All right, I'll carry.
Can you guys hear me?
Yeah,
Yeah.
I hear you.
Poggers.
I hear you twice.
What? One
Oh, dude,
IRL?
these are some
Yeah, I heard
sick
you one
parses.
IRL.
Oh, that's
I'll close the
weird.
door.
Why the fuck are these guys tryharding? There's like no troll picks or role swaps.
What? No. Wait, Golden Guardians can still make playoffs,
Yeah, but like, why are they tryharding?
right?
Yeah, dude, come on. This is content day.
True.
Yeah, this is for the fans, guys.
Neo won with Jungle Gragas.
Yeah.
Does the quality of the stream look weird to you guys?
The volume for me is also really, really quiet. The stream.
Yeah, I'm pretty high up.
The quality looks weird to me. I don't know if I need to refresh.
I think mine looks okay.
Oh
Oh!
This is so dirty that that works.
Oh!
That's so dirty
And
that that
Licorice
works.
TP's in to do nothing. Have his dick
Yikes.
in his hand.
Yeah.
Do you think Stixxay was screaming for TP?
No, definitely not. He's getting dove so quickly there. A
Oh!
playstyle of just flash auto.
Oh my!
Wow.
Wait, he almost
Both.
died.
Yeah, he had so much patience on the last flash. Like, if that clips him, he dies. And it's so close. Damn, that was really close. Oh, the whole thing. Like, I thought a playstyle was going to flash auto finish that.
Yeah.
I think if he went for the flash auto, he would guaranteed die to tower.
Maybe. If he procs Triumph, I think he might live. It's one turret shot only.
Did people run Triumph on Sylas, not Presence?
I don't know.
I think they run Triumph. I've seen that a good amount. Let's
What do you have?
see the stab again. Level
Oh,
2 to
yeah.
level 3. The real, like, honestly, the real misplay is just Stixxay not flashing this, but, like, he's dead anyways. It's just that maybe they have to commit one extra flash,
This
which, like,
TP is so
raise.
late, is the thing I don't get. Like,
Yeah.
they're already out before he even starts the TP.
Yeah, that was weird.
I was memeing a bit.
Stop the memes, bro.
Maymays.
No. I want a
Respect.
meme.
I would have.
Yes. Memes.
Yeah, I hope Hecarim Udyr meta comes back for Worlds. That was when junglers really got to prove how good they were. None of these cheesy carry picks.
Oh, raise.
Only bear slapping.
Oh,
Oh.
raise.
They're getting
This is winning.
fisted.
This is winning for Iconic. This is winning for. He's level
Oh!
six.
Ray's got double stunned. Oh my god.
Oh, he wasted his R.
What was the plan there? Like level 5 Hecarim versus level 6 Viego? Did they just not? They didn't
Holy
have like
fuck, a Varus jungle.
Dude, that's almost as good as action Viego. Jungle.
Oh wait, it's Viego jungle. Okay.
Yeah, he was playing as Varus. It confused me for a sec.
Mm.
Oh my god! I get so annoyed when I play against, like, I'm not in the game, so it doesn't affect me like mentally. But like when I play against someone who does something that's super not allowed and it doesn't go punished, I get so fucking sad. It's so frustrating.
Yeah.
It's like somebody forces an all-in on me, and the only reason why they like they force it all in and they win, but it's like if I just played it like a human or if my support played it like a human, we would win. And I'm just like, this guy's so fucking stupid. Like, I want him to do it again next game. It's so frustrating.
The classic fucking, he's not good, I'm just bad. One of my friends I started learning League with always fucking would say shit like that. He's like, he's getting shit on, he's like, this guy's not even good, he's so bad. I'm like, and then why is he shitting on you? Oh man, so good.
I felt that way when I was playing Strive sometimes. Like, I could tell something was so obvious, but I just couldn't properly punish it.
Wait, when you're what?
Guilty Gear.
Guilty Gear Strive.
Oh,
yeah.
Game. Okay.
Yeah.
Do like grab.
Now, in fighting games, it's really obnoxious because you're like, this guy's just so trash, but I'm actually worse because I can't punish him.
Yeah, like.
Wait, somebody in my. One of my mods banned Casper, the guy who types like a fucking maniac.
No! Casper!
Damn. We can't have this guy banned, guys. He's a legend.
Oh yeah, I was gonna say, like, grabs in that game are like 2 frames or some shit, or 1 frame, I don't know, they're so fast. And it's just, like, I can smell them coming, but I swear to god, it's so hard to stop them.
Wow, Licorice is actually just
blasting
1v2.
Oh my god, wait, a Blaze Olive could have taken a Hecarim ult.
No, but he can run at them with Rakan.
No, I think Rakan was the right move there. It was...
Yeah. Yeah, okay, I could see that. Maybe he thought Hecarim would die before he had the chance to take the ult, but pretty sure he could have got it.
Yeah.
Hey, your guy's stream doesn't look blurry at all to you.
Here, I'll come check yours real quick.
Did you have you changed the quality to 1080? Ramada?
Yeah, it's on 1080.
It does look a bit blurry now that you mention it. Like, blurrier than normal. And the audio is, like, fucked for me. It's so quiet. Oh my god!
It
Solo
does not
Bolo?
Seem blurry.
Wait. That's so tilting. Wow, that's so tilting. The Braum comes in to save the day. Dude. A Blaze Olive is actually playing, like, fucking shit. And he's just getting, like, so lucky. That's all there is to it. He's just getting so lucky. Like, there's no way he's baiting to the last possible millisecond for Braum to save him with E and then get the trade kill. Like,
yeah, I don't know. Let's see it.
This is the kind of shit that I mean. Like, Insanity should be like slightly frustrated about this because he literally did everything wrong.
Oh wait. Oh my god, wait.
He should have flashed earlier. Like, Insanity obviously misplayed as well, like, really badly. When Braum comes in with the W.
Oh my god, and then Braum lives.
Dude, that's so sad. Oh my god.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a fucking tilter for sure.
Yeah. I mean, he should be annoyed, but also realize his flash was too late. Dixie somehow stabilized this lane after getting Dove level 3.
Ooh, Emax Kalista, and no points in W.
Well, Emax...
The no points W is pretty normal when you have a melee support like Braum. If it's like Leona, I think W is good. If it's Thresh, I think W's good. But like, if your support's not going to auto-attack, then you're not going to proc the... It's 14%
Isn't
it of their max.
Isn't that some fucking crazy percent of their health?
Yeah, 14%.
Yeah, it's a lot.
Right? Or is it
12? That really not worth a point, dude? That's always struck me as odd. Like, that seems like such a fucking high number. 14%.
It really is high, but...
It really is high. I think when you're doing Qmax, it feels...
Yeah, I think if you're doing Emax and you have no point in W, you're kind of trolling. But if you're doing Qmax, I think it makes sense. Because you need points in E.
Yeah, I agree. The damage, like when you're maxing Q, you're doing it for the big burst because you're getting 65 damage per point. And then having high points in E actually matters a lot more than just having like one. I don't know. If you have Thresh though, I think W is really insane. Any range support.
Yeah.
Because you're constantly getting it. And you can also get it from your... Wait, am I crazy? You can Q somebody and then your support can auto?
Yeah.
Is that right, Sneak?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
They like set up auto attack and then you Q him and just does a billion damage.
Yeah, because your Thresh's auto is also like super empowered, so
mm-hmm.
that feels fucking good. I don't know, Kalista in LCS has me like feeling pretty mixed on the results.
Mm-hmm.
It's definitely a champ that's not that, it's not that hard to play, but it's, I don't know, it's very like narrow with the win con, I think.
I don't like it in this kind of comp as much. I think you need some kind of like scaler on your team for Kalista to be good. She's kind of like Ashe.
That's my thoughts as well.
Like,
I don't know. I think Ashe is actually a late game carry.
Really?
I'm playing 6 item Ashe. I'm fucking so happy.
I always thought of Ashe as like just, she spikes on like 3 items pretty hard and then does not get another spike after that.
I feel like when you get IE and then you curve that and it's like a Lord dumps into like a defensive item, I don't know. Ashe is fucking crazy.
Yeah, you can do a lot of damage for sure. But I think it kind of depends what you're playing
against.
It's hard
to actually like, get that damage off because she's so vulnerable.
Yes, that is correct. Like the hardest part is actually getting chances to do the damage.
Yeah, but I mean, I think that's like a pretty relevant thing when assessing a champ's strength, because like Master Yi, right? He's gonna do a fuck ton of damage, but you don't actually get to do it.
Yeah, that's fair.
That's true.
Like Tristana's damage feels really easy to get that off. Like the upfront of Hail Blades in her E, it's like probably over 1,000 damage right away.
Mm-hmm.
So,
and if you're a dive champion playing against Triss, it's way harder to kill Triss than an Ashe. Like if you're playing against an Ashe, it's like every diver's wet dream. You're just like, yes, an immobile, slow champion who like has nothing they can do.
Yeah, if they get on him, there's no way to live.
I mean, I think it's probably just gonna come down to the next dragon fight, right? IMT's got the scaling comp. Masterwork item's gonna come in soon.
Yeah, IMT kind of has their backs to the wall here. I think there's a couple of like bright spots for them. Like one of them is that I think Cassio is probably one of the best mid picks that they could have had this game. Like quadruple melee. Obviously, something that Cassio struggles with is range, but she's really good at kiting melees. And also, the only range champion is being Kalista. Kalista fucking hates playing against Cassio. It's impossible to dodge her ulti because you're locked in auto animation.
Yeah.
And the miasma is fucking horrible to play against. So
what happens if you're in the miasma? Do you just not jump?
You cannot jump. Yeah. So
you just sit there.
Yes. You have to choose. You either auto attack or you move. You cannot do both. If you auto attack, you're just standing still.
Dude, even though Golden Guardians is in a better position, I still feel like I'd rather be IMT in this game.
Yes.
Because like
yes,
I think Golden
I
Guardians,
unless they kill here, but Iconic dies instantly.
Ooh.
Destiny is 1 HP. This is.
Ooh, he ate the world.
I mean,
nice.
This is a weird fight for Immortals to be taking, in my opinion. Like, this is a totally unnecessary fight.
No, they're winning it. They're winning it.
Wait, they missed the Ornal.
Yeah.
Blaze Olive.
That was really
I can hit it with my eyes closed.
Yeah, Blaze Olive should have closed his eyes. He did it too early. It's like he headbutted it, but it was in front of Revenge. If he waits a little bit more, it'll actually hit him.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, I don't think that's too bad. If I was on Golden Guardians, this is when you start talking about sums, right? You're talking about Cassio, no flash, Rakan and Revenge have no flash. But on your side, you didn't blow anything. 5 flashes versus 2, or actually 5 flashes versus 1, because Xerxes has Ghost. That is a really strong position to be in for drag, and I'd be okay with giving up a little bit of gold for that.
Wait, yeah, that's actually, I didn't realize they all flash there.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Blaze Olive is trolling the shit out of this right here. Like,
damn,
what?
Huh.
His team wasn't even set up for taking anything. Not even ready to take mid off that, so.
Yeah. I mean, I usually don't like talking about scaling as, like, a definitive thing in League, but, like, I think this is a situation where Golden Guardians all their champs are just too much of the same, in my opinion. Like, they don't really have that late game carry type champ.
Mm-hmm.
It's like all early game bruisers.
I think their comp is pretty cohesive though, because they're just playing to get a Blaze Olive to get one reset. And when you're playing a two thread comp, I would say Immortals is a two thread comp, right? It's just Cassio and poke Varus, but like Varus doesn't do particularly like that much damage if you're banking on him doing a lot. So if they can kill Cassio, that's all that it comes down to. Like, can they kill Cassio with no flash in this next fight? I feel like if I'm Golden Guardians, I'm feeling pretty good. Renekton has flash stun, Kalista can follow, Braum can follow, like everyone can follow on the first CC, and if their main damage dealer has no flash, it's gonna be really hard for them to stop drag. Like, I guess we're gonna have to see how it plays out, but
yeah,
I mean, Immortals comp, but I hate that their backs are to the wall right here.
Yeah, I think the flash is all being down for this dragon fight. It's pretty relevant.
Yeah. It just takes one person to start the chain, you know, like even if it's something pretty weak, like if it's just I don't know, Kalista ulting or Silas hitting a slow or an Everfrost, then when Renekton lands is stunned, it's over. The fight is lost.
Mm-hmm.
What's the name of the upgraded Prowler Claw?
Uh-oh. It's a test.
Who the hell knows?
Oh, it's Sandshrike's Claw. The fuck is a Sandshrike?
I don't know.
Golden Guardians should just give mid turret. Who cares? You're getting outskilled so hard, you should only fight over drag. This is exactly what Immortals wants. Don't A-Ram with 4 melee.
Wait, they're trying to go on Ornn. No, they need to come for flanks. You should not come for
Like, I hate how they're playing here. They should have just been okay with giving mid. They're actually
going to Baron now.
No, they're trolling so hard. Licorice blew his ulti at that time too. Like, don't start Baron. Please, for the love of God, do not start Baron. Are you fucking serious?
They want to so bad.
Oh my God, no. Why are they hitting it?
They really want it, dude. That's the thing.
Oh my God, no. I've seen this before. Like, why would you do this against Ornn? He's gonna ult. Ornn's gonna ult, bro.
I mean, they have Braum, but still gonna be awkward.
Oh, which Ornn's gonna ult?
And time holds my revenge.
Wait,
that
solo.
Was a thick ass arrow.
Yeah, that Varus Q. Varus. Jesus.
Golden Guardians is not playing their comp correctly at all. Like, when you play this kind of gangbang dive comp, like, you can't come from the front. You gotta come from multiple angles.
I like it when they hit it from the back, personally.
They should really be hitting it from the back, but they're. If you just walk at him, I don't think you ever win that unless the other team's trolling.
Oh, Cassio's going to drag.
Dude, all Golden Guardians has to do is kill Cassio before her flash comes up. It's 30 seconds. Like, they had the longest time ever. Just literally should have played for drag. You could have gotten Ocean Soul, and if Cassio walks up, she's going to die.
Wait, they have no wards, so Destiny W'd in.
You can see Kalista's autos, right?
Yeah, you can see and hear them.
I think you hear them. I don't know. Do you see them?
Like, if you're over the wall.
Oh, wait, they're.
You will
finish.
Know. No, they're
oh
not.
Oh my God.
They have no damage.
Insanity's giga far.
Insanity.
Iconic's dead.
Oh wait. Ray's got one piece.
Insanity's coming.
Wait, Hecarim
nice
is
dodge
dead.
By Licorice there. Where Insanity gets tagged. He has a flash.
Oh!
Oh, his. Just one, two more autos.
I think I'm a little behind. I'm gonna speed up.
Okay.
They're gonna hit.
They could look Baron again. They could look.
I think
everyone's gonna vamp.
Did it. Yeah.
What happened to Raze? Did he get flashed on by Hecarim? Sorry, Renekton.
I think so. He definitely died without using
flashed on by Hecarim.
Yeah. His team's Hecarim with Ghost flash on him.
Dude, another W over the wall. Oh my God. It's too funny.
I mean, even if Golden Guardians gets this Baron, hold up.
Wait.
Insanity?
Sticks
I think Insanity's fucked. He's
yeah, Insanity's
way too
gonna
in.
Die here.
Oh my God! What is happening?
Insanity kind of played that like an ape.
Yeah, he's trolling hard. Oh, so good for Golden Guardians here, getting Baron off the end of this.
Are they gonna hit it?
Up her drag. Okay, no, they're gonna wait. They're gonna wait.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure Stixxay could have finished Baron. By the way, I feel like he should have committed
into
the pit.
Right here, first one.
No, the last one. On the end, yeah.
Yeah. Let's see what happened to Raze here. No. He did get flashed on, but It was actually Hector Multi that started it. It was the Silas Hector Multi. I guess he just wasn't mentally prepared for Silas to have Hector Multi and hit him with it. It's kind of understandable, but pretty new mistake too.
Mm-hmm.
You're talking right here. He could have. Yeah. I agree.
Like, he just commits into the pit, and his teammates just kill the other guys.
But I could see it. It's 3k HP, and if he doesn't hit Cassio there, he's kind of selling his team out for Baron.
Yeah.
So it's a tough decision. 3k HP, like.
Yeah, it was
be sketchy.
I don't know, I feel like it was just a few autos away because he had so many spears in it.
Yeah.
Spear would have done, or the E would have done like 1800.
Really?
Yeah.
Shit, that's a lot of damage.
Golden Guardians really like hitting Baron, dude.
Licorice is going to die for free here. This is really like this. Trash fight. This is such a bad fight. You need to get
hang
the fuck
on.
Out. Oh my god, wait, no, hold on, they're turning it.
Oh my god.
Two threat comp and one threat dies instantly.
Oh!
Yeah. Damn.
Oh my god, this is so sad. Golden Guardians played this game so bad, but like, just winning.
Yeah, man, like, I actually think Revenge played that fight pretty poorly. It looked like Licorice was totally caught.
Yes, I agree.
But then Revenge just, like, got himself blasted.
Mm-hmm.
I want to see the replay.
Same.
Licorice in that spot with no flash? Everyone on Immortal should be able to hit and do damage without taking damage. That's...
Let's see it.
Let's see it again.
They're starting another fight when Insanity is nowhere near.
Yeah.
Why is Insanity taking this god-awful path? Are you serious, bro?
Wait, Insanity's target choice is actually Troll. Why is he not
what
hitting
What are
Licorice?
You doing? Insanity is griefing the shit
Insanity
out of this game.
Really, really shitting his pants
no,
on this
it's,
one.
No, it's not Revenge fault. Like, he could play a little
better
with ulti
you're
faster,
right.
But...
I didn't notice what Insanity was doing.
Yeah.
Hmm.
That was super dirty. He's like hitting the Braum, running into their whole team instead of killing the Renekton. That's way too overextended.
So when Renekton pressed stopwatch, right? Like, that's like every Cassio, every Caitlyn player. Like, they just know like you just always put your W down.
Yeah,
on
exactly.
Someone who's
Zonius. Yeah.
Because like afterwards, they're so fucking dead. It's not even funny. But he didn't even realize. I think Renekton was like behind him. He's so tunnel vision on killing Braum.
Yeah, Renekton looked unkillable. Because Cassio didn't W him.
Yeah.
Or even shoot him.
Yeah. Well, I mean,
he wasn't attacking him at all.
Yeah, like, Renekton stopwatch. So, like, if Cassio started hitting him, she would have done damage. But, like, the W is what matters.
Yeah.
Because then he can't actually
really
move.
I really hate, again, how Golden Guardians is playing this. Why do you care about mid? Why does mid wave matter at all? Just drag them into the jungle and play for flank. You're not going to flank them when the enemy team is mid. Like, this is great. This is great. I want to see.
Yeah, I think this positioning's fine.
Yeah.
Don't even think about the wave mid. Like, the only thing that matters is getting the fight where you're collapsing on them in the river when they're stuck.
Oh.
Dragon's
oh,
dead.
this is awkward, but I like it.
The Blaze Olive went in a little too early.
But he secured his team the soul. I think it's fine.
Yeah. Oh, yo, iconic, God. Upgrade your teammate's item. Upgrade a teammate's item. Come on, dude, upgrade it. No.
And Sandy's still no flash.
Dude, I don't know if you have time for it.
Dude, just fucking do it. Just fucking do it, dude.
I honestly don't think it works. I'm pretty sure. Like, I think you can start it, and then it just cancels because you run out of time.
Oh.
That's so funny.
Really?
I think so.
Maybe you have to have, like, perfect timing. Like, you have to, like,
It was a thing when Viego first came out. People are saying they removed it.
Oh, wow.
Rip.
Yeah, like, the problem is the combat. Like, you can't be in combat.
Yeah, you have to, like, wait. So let his, like, ghost... I don't know. I'm just theorycrafting here, but, like, wait until the ghost, like, fucking almost times out and you're out of combat. Then you take the ghost and you quickly upgrade.
Yeah, I think that's the only way to do it, if it even works then. Like, you hold the ghost as long as possible.
How crazy
is
that,
so
though?
OP.
If you kill Ornn and you do this play that we're talking about, if it works, right? Assuming it works. You go up at least 1,000 gold every time that happens.
Yeah.
Like, that is so value. Holy moly.
Someone's saying they removed it, but I don't know.
Yeah, I'm seeing that too.
I think, like, everything that we were talking about, like, Immortals comp being better front to back is true, but I think when your two threats are and one of them are Pokeferris, it's so much pressure on Cassio to hard carry the fight. So much pressure on her.
Yeah.
I mean, if Cassio gets fucking jumped by everyone and Viego gets a reset, but your AD carry is like Tristana, I think you have a somewhat decent chance of winning the fight afterwards, but.
Yeah, yeah, I think you're right about the two threat part. It's definitely a weakness.
Yeah. When I play Pokeverus, I just try to tell my teammates that play as many carries as we can. Because like Pokeverus actually functions the exact same with or without a frontline. He's not an AD carry that like needs an Ornn or like even really wants one.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely.
Sorry guys, I'm back.
Welcome back.
Dude, these names are actually so weird.
Yeah.
Looking up the list of all of them.
Yeah.
Yo, Rocket Belt turns into Upgraded Arrow Pack.
What?
What the fuck?
These seem like
actual bad names. I feel like they just went for
names.
Like the weirdest, trollest names ever.
Yeah.
Actually, I feel like the like natural progression before where it's like Sunfire Cape goes to Forge Fire Cape and like
yeah, that sounds way
goes
better.
Into Molten Edge. It sounds so much better.
Because it's obvious.
Stixxay had such a sick play there. Wow. That's
Wait,
not easy.
How did Insanity end up here?
Destiny is just dead. Well, this looks like GG.
Yeah, yep. It's over. No damage, Wait. Right? Just no damage. Also, Ocean Soul is giving all these bruisers super value.
Wait, did you see what they did to Raze? They like triple warded the blast gun. He's just hitting wards.
That's so sick. Warding blast cones is like something I've not practiced at all. That's awesome.
Same.
Yeah.
I want to see it. I'm going back.
That's fucking sick, man.
He's actually just
trapped. You'd love to see little mechanics like that.
Heart stuck autoing wards.
Okay, I'm gonna go back and watch. That's I also funny. Want to point out Stixxay at the very beginning of the fight, Cleanse Flash, Destiny's Flash ulti. Pretty smooth.
Oh, yeah.
That was good. Oh my god, they actually.
Insanity ended up in
Dude,
the
how the hell are you watching
ever.
This, Sneaky? Like, what the fuck are.
I mean, I was watching them chase Varus. Because he flashed. I was like, ooh, is he gonna die?
Yeah. Yeah. And he's just auto's the worst.
He's just cursed.
That's great.
What's your thought on the drama around 100 Thieves putting in their academy team?
Oh.
There's like the Santorin side where it's like being butthurt that they're not taking every match completely seriously. And then there's the other side where people are like, they can do whatever the fuck they want.
Yeah, I mean, I think it doesn't actually matter that they're putting in their academy team. I don't think there's anything wrong with it. I mean, it does kind of suck that it sort of messes with the standings, but I don't know. I mean, I think if it truly affects just the seeding, if it affected like the last playoff slot, I think that would be more messed up rather than just the seeding. Because it's like, I don't know, there's a loser's bracket. There's definitely already built-in fail safes for if a team just messes up based on, like, you know, whatever match is coming because of that.
Yeah, dude, the thing I brought up was, remember back in, like, our first or second season when we were just shitting on everyone and we were saying, like, you know, if we finish first, like, once we get first locked in, we're going to, like, pick brand jungle.
Yeah.
And I remember the community sentiment back then was, like, really not about it.
Mm-hmm.
People were, like, pissed that we were talking about doing that. So we didn't end up doing it because, like, people would be too butthurt.
Yeah.
But now people are like, yeah, do whatever you want.
Oh, you wanted... I just got it. You wanted to play brand jungle because you went, like, 0-27 in a brand jungle game while you were drunk on stream.
Nope, that was later.
That was
way
later.
That was also brand support.
Yeah.
Oh, my bad.
Yeah, you just wanted to play brand Annie with balls.
Oh, dude, that lane was insane.
It was not that bad.
Yeah, it wasn't.
It actually wasn't. The fire.
Dude, I remember, like, we played Teemo. We were talking about this before, but, like, we played Teemo, and then on TL we played Glacials, and no one seemed super butthurt.
Yeah, it's...
All in good fun. Because those matches didn't matter.
Yeah, I mean, this one, like, sort of does, right? It's why it's, like, a little maybe questionable, but I think it's fine for 100 Thieves.
No. For 100 Thieves, it doesn't matter for them.
Yeah.
It only matters for the other teams, but like, just get good. Like, why would they care about your standing?
Exactly.
They're only interested in giving their main team a break day. Like, you don't think they deserve the break day after fucking
Like, it's
locking in their seed?
It's valuable for 100 Thieves to take the break for their team.
Yeah. You want to be like unaffected by how other teams are playing their match or like putting in their academy team or not, then play better next split and get a higher seeding.
Yeah, for sure.
So I think Santorin's kind of being a snowflake here.
I mean, isn't it because it potentially makes them, like Team Liquid, have to play C9 or something?
They're playing C9 right now, and maybe if they, I don't know, like depending on maybe on the results, they have to, yeah.
I thought that was part of it.
Yeah, I mean, I can see why Santorin's annoyed about it. I probably would be too if I was in his position, but like, I don't think you need to like take to social media and act like, you know, all high and mighty about it, being like, oh,
yeah, exactly. You just be like, man, this fucking sucks for me. Like, I wish that they would try hard.
Yeah, I'd be like, all right, fuck these guys.
Better for you. I understand. Damn, dude. I would have loved to see you come back after C9, join a team, and like fucking demolish them. Actually, that would be so satisfying to watch.
Yeah, I think that one probably would have felt pretty real, considering how long I was on C9. For a lot of people.
Yeah. I remember for Jensen, it was...
It'd be the same thing in Bjergsen, too. Yeah, Jensen, Bjergsen. Like, any of the big guys that are, like, stuck to a team and then just leave. Or, you know, get kicked, whatever.
Hardly any of those players fucking switched. I mean, Jensen switched from C9 to TL. Bjergsen never switched teams.
Yep.
Miki never switched teams.
Yep.
Doublelift never switched teams.
Loyalty.
Nah.
Meteos never switched teams.
That's true. Facts.
I always, whenever I was on a team, I always just thought this is going to be my team until I retire. Like, I had no doubt in my mind I was going to stay on CLG until I was done playing. And then I was like, okay. And then I joined TSM and I was like, this is it. This is the team. I want to be here forever. Okay. And I joined TL.
How many of the teams did you leave versus how many of them just replaced you against your will?
What? I got replaced against my will every single time.
Oh.
There's not a single time I didn't get replaced against my will.
Damn. So you're actually the loyal one.
Yeah.
Yes.
These hoes, I mean, teams ain't loyal.
These hoes ain't loyal. I mean, it's fine. It's a business.
It's just business.
Yeah, I mean, if they don't want the best end, I got player the fucking of all last time, left, that's on
so
them.
Right,
it would actually feel so shitty if you got replaced and then all of a sudden, and then like, your team was your team just like became insane because of it. And like part of like my like internal satisfaction is probably, I don't know, like sneaky watching fucking C9 just suck dick and never make worlds with Sven. It's like, oh my god, just get the lotion out. This is this is great. I gotta move my cam.
Yeah, I was gonna say that reminds me of when Impact would make the joke. It's like, just call each other business friends.
yeah. Actually, Impact always said that. We're just business friends.
Yeah.
Business friends.
It's so good. It's like your teammates. Yeah. You're just business friends.
That's actually how LCS is.
I've made like real lifelong friendships from LCS, though. It depends. I mean, you guys did too, obviously.
Yeah.
Fucking.
Yeah, I mean, that was like the original team. And I mean, I say that shit all the time, how like it used to feel like teams were, you know, fucking family. Now it's coworkers.
Yeah.
Yeah, for sure.
Business friends.
Yep.
With benefits.
Oh.
Business friends with benefits.
Who do you think is the closest friend you made Doublelift in your time as a pro player? Like, former teammate? Bjergsen. Bjergsen?
Yeah. I was really close with Vincent when we were playing together, and I was really close with Core when we were playing together, but, like, I was close with Soren even when we weren't playing together. So I think that's a level above.
Gotcha.
I mean, we were also friends. Like, if we saw each other, we'd definitely, like, say hi, catch up, and, like, go hang out, but...
Make out.
Yeah, exactly. A little bit of benefits.
Oh, Perks just missed a cannon!
Oh my god, I'm slightly behind you. I gotta speed it up. Time?
7.
Oh, 8.
8.
9.
Yeah,
okay.
10. 11. I can pause if you guys are behind.
I'm like a split second behind you. 16, 17, 18.
Okay, yeah, I paused for like half a second. We're good now.
Okay. Oh.
TP coming in.
Oh, shit.
I love the flash root.
Damn, core is dead as hell.
Core is just getting fucking 10-manned.
Yeah.
That is literally four people here.
Jensen TP's in. I mean, I guess he gets... Or no, he doesn't even get the wave because Tactical's there.
No. Jensen needs to TP in so Tactical can go to the wave. That's what makes the play like salvageable. If Tactical doesn't,
I guess, yeah,
get able to go back on his turret and farm those 15 creeps, it's fucking game over.
Yeah, that's fair.
It sucks for Jensen, but his wave is looking good mid anyway. So, like, he TPs and gets nothing, but like so does Perks. He gets, actually, he doesn't get nothing. He gets a kill.
Yeah, I mean, that makes sense if it's the difference between them being able to like redive Tactical a second later. Do you think they would wait that long, though?
They don't need to, because Tactical is playing with no info.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
Secret flank?
Oh.
Bulk and Q flashing the minion, let's go.
Oh, Tactical's still
Tactical's
dead, though.
Fucking toast.
Yeah.
Oh, jeez. Wait,
where
maybe not.
Wait.
Maybe not.
Wait.
No, he's...
Oh, my
he's
God.
Okay.
Oh!
Wow.
My God.
That went, like, up his ass and then through his dick or something, that Felios Q...
Yeah. Up his ass and through his...
Dude, it went straight through him.
Is that what happened?
Wait.
Santorin?
Wait, Santorin?
What?
Oh my God. That was a little
ambitious.
Spicy for me. Oof. Tactical living that. I mean, Leona is actually such great peel. Because she has a stun on such a low cooldown.
Dude, watch the Aphelios Q, though. Like, does it actually look like it missed?
Yeah. He's hiding behind Korra's hitbox. It's like Jhin ulti.
But it like...
Yo, Vulcan giga trolled this dude.
Yeah.
Yeah, he did.
That would have been the kill. Alright, watch the Q.
I mean, Tactical just steps back into Korra's hitbox.
Oh, okay. Ooh. It looked closer before. That didn't look very close.
Damn, that's a fucking shame that Tactical doesn't die there. It still makes him lose a lot, but... Wave was being frozen that whole time. This game looks extremely hard for Tactical to play. I think playing against TF with no cleanse is already hard, but I think Braum is really good against Ezreal. Also, Camille is really good against Ezreal, in my opinion, just because there's not really any way to outplay her ulti.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
God, actually, we didn't even really talk about the comps, but both the comps seem so good. Like, really, really great poke, disengage, and still a decent frontline for TL. And for C9, it's like, TF Camille needs to get a good angle, and they have, like, some stability from bot lane.
Yeah, I would imagine, I think I'd rather be C9 a little bit, just because it seems like they have the edge when it comes to splitting.
Wait, can they actually do this? This looks terrible.
No. Fudge tanked. It's not good.
What? This is so troll.
Huh. Does it work?
It does work.
Oh!
Wow!
That...
Wow.
Actually worked! Okay, I mean, Jensen should pick him up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That looked so giga-scuffed.
I didn't even think they would get the kill.
Yeah, same. Yeah.
Did
Alfari play that weird?
No, I think he didn't have cooldowns.
Well, he took like an early shot, right?
I want to see this shit again.
You have to think about also, like, in these cases, like, who is that better for? And I think for Camille, TF, that's so much better for them to kill Alfari and get his flash. Like,
yeah, I don't think TL feels make every... bad, though.
Like, yeah, the, like, it feels good to get the play better. on the reset. So we just have to see how is Alfari going to play for the rest of it.
Hold up.
Wow, he's just getting solo boloed.
Oh,
two
my.
Two levels God. Down, Xinjiao solo
flash.
Oh, no.
Wait, can we not just fight this? Oh, maybe not.
Give him the E to this minion. Nice. Oh, my God. That actually saves his flash. That's so important. Okay, now
huge.
You're really fucking sad if you're TL. Because your mid and top both have no flash, and the enemy team is playing, like, the highest kill potential top lane that, like, probably exists. It's just all kill champs.
How did Blabber slide in that bush?
Blast cone, maybe?
Yeah, I'd imagine blast cone.
Yeah, because like
dive angle by
oh shit
Jensen TP preemptive, please preemptive. Good.
Oh.
Maybe.
wait.
Maybe this means... Oh,
wait, Sven took an extra shot from that. Oh, God.
Dude, Jensen just keeps getting cleanup kills.
Yeah.
Every time. This is so good for Jensen.
That's nasty.
Yeah. Yeah, I think looking bot there was not the move. Like, if I was on C9, I would have much rather seen them just keep making, like, re-ganks and re-dives on top. But, like, I can understand it.
Yeah, I agree. I think small this window. Is a game. If you get a strong Camille, TL has, like, really no answer.
There's also the possibility that Perks just miscalculated Jensen's TP. Because, like, you would pretty much never go for that dive if you knew the enemy mid was going to TP.
Alright, let's see this again.
Right there, they're pinging that ward behind C9 in the lane for Jensen to TP, and then he realizes, oh wait, I'm not ganking them, they're already diving us.
I actually think so this play, Sven jumped the gun a little bit here. Yeah. Like, he started tanking. I think if he doesn't do that, it's... Oh my god!
No way. No way that just happened.
Oh my god.
Holy fuck.
No way.
Poor is just literally...
Dude, Jensen
the best player ever.
No.
Fucking surfing the map as Azir, bro.
Dude.
Yeah.
That's insane.
That
the
happened
gold
again.
Is still only even.
Fudge went for a fast dive with no minions because they felt like TL was coming, but they just miscalculated how fast TL would be there. Like, Fudge could actually commit to the dive if there were minions. But they did that dive completely, zero minions involved. And it just, like, barely doesn't work.
Yeah. I mean, dude, props to TL for countering every single one of these plays. Like, yeah. It's not easy to play against some shit like this. Like, especially TF when he's just roaming around. As Azir, too. Azir, no cleanse. I think Jensen's playing pretty fucking well. Just right place, right time.
Yeah, constantly covering top. Look, this is so tragic. That TP comes in, there's only one minion. And then it just dies, and there's nothing to tank.
And they just... Blabber backs off, too.
Yeah, he probably thought it was a free one.
Blabber Fudge was tanking, so he probably... Well, honestly, he should have kept tanking, because he has ult. Like, Camille ult drops tower aggro. I think Fudge misplayed that.
He could have played a lot better. I mean, Leona ulti saving him was actually so important there. Like, core hitting fucking the peel ulti.
Yeah, the thing is, if the wave is in... And they back off like that, it actually... The Leona ult doesn't do anything, because the tower would start shooting minions, but because there's no minions, it instantly went on Blabber. Without resetting. Cooling down. C9's not fucked or anything, but like this is way better for TL than it should be.
Yeah, I think C9's not fucked because all the gold is on one person.
Oh. Holy shit.
Nice.
Fucking
Jensen,
dude.
He is owning this game.
What the fuck?
That was nasty.
Jensen is playing fucking insanely well right now.
Yeah. Sven is kind of overextended. I wouldn't feel comfortable playing like this, but
Andy's
did
dead.
Some cover. Wow.
And he's gone.
And he's gone.
Damn, that is a fat shutdown to Xin Zhao. Not the guy you want to get that.
Yeah. Jensen's still so.
At the same time, though, like I think Azir's one of the best mages at playing against Xin. Right? Like Well, you can just shuffle him when he goes in, or you can shuffle him away. Like, Zen only has like one thing. He goes in and gets shuffled like to his death, or he just goes in and gets shuffled away and kind of doesn't do anything.
I don't really feel that much pressure playing against Azir as Zen.
Oh, really? Well,
yeah, because like you can just stand back, like Azir can't hit you when your ult's going, and then you slide in, pound his ass.
Ooh. Rick saw blood right here when he had Ignite off his spellbook.
Ooh, Jensen even dodged the wild card on his slide in.
No, he didn't. He got it.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I was watching that too. Wow, Jensen.
He got the shield from the E, I guess.
I thought that Blabber flashed there.
Yeah, I guess he did get hit.
No, he did flash. Blabber.
Oh.
It might have been the spec bug.
I think he flash E'd and then W'd.
Flash E and then W, then yeah.
Wait, flash E'd what? A minion?
I mean, we were talking about though, all of the gold on TL is banked on Jensen or was, and their whole team as a whole, they're down 1k gold. So when I look at mid items, even though Jensen has 5 kills, he's pretty much even with Perks in terms of like 4 item completion.
That, I mean, part of that's TF passive. Like,
yeah, exactly. So TL made some really great moves so far, but like somehow through all of that, they didn't really get ahead early game.
Yeah.
Fucking Ocean Soul, or Cloud Soul. That's not what you want to see if you're C9. It's pretty fucking useless.
Yeah, not a lot of
value. No one can really use it except for maybe Zin. I don't know.
Oh my god, we're getting a fight?
Ooh, Fudge got baited by Stopwatch, but can he just kill Alfari instead?
Wait, Core's gonna live?
Yeah, Alfari's trapped.
Okay. Wow. They're just dead.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just dead. Dude, fucking Xin Zhao's team fighting is just too good. Cause like
Jensen really messed up. Like, he shouldn't let Camille go in like that. That's so troll. She had no flash. Like, why did he just not shuffle Camille on the TP? Just maybe he didn't trust his timing, and then he like, then she just instantly eat away.
Yeah. Oh.
Oh my God, Fudge is gonna kill Jensen here. Oh, maybe not.
No, is Perk's gonna do it. Jensen. Is Perk's gonna do it?
Wow, he got juked. He actually got juked. Just on a slash anyways, so wasn't that big of a payoff.
Calculated. Risk-free play.
Right here, like, if they have perfect vision, they just know the tactical's dead. He has no flash. Right that position, he's dead to TF. But obviously, there's no map pack and Perks is doing blue, so. Still, right here! That's a kill!
Yeah.
Damn. Perks actually peels off blue to be at the fight. What a team player.
Oh my god.
It's just another 5v5.
They just can't do anything to fucking Blabber.
Yeah, every time god, that shuffle like that.
Large. That was a large scoop.
But it doesn't do
anything.
Oh
my god, wait, doesn't it?
Oh. Wait, maybe it does.
I think it does.
Holy how's Jensen allowed to carry this hard?
Holy shit.
What
that,
the fuck?
That was nasty.
Jensen, calm down, dude. Does this match even matter?
that Zonya's by Jensen was fucking crazy as well.
Every part of that fight
he got
was insane. A
that
looks
nasty
so lost.
Scoop, a nasty Zonya.
Yeah.
Nasty stabs.
Nah, he's smurfing his ass off this game. It's crazy after that fight that you look at the gold and they're actually still losing. Like, how hard can he carry this game? Minions killed him.
Really?
A little range minion auto attack flying. That seemed pretty cocky from Perks walking up at the end there.
Yes, I think that was great. I think that was really good by Tactical to play off the gold card timing out. It was like almost perfect timing. It was perfect timing, I think.
Perks actually could have gold carded Jensen here. Wait,
he blue carded. It was
anyways.
Yeah.
I think the initial card he threw, though, he shot it at Santorin instead of Jensen.
Yeah. Which, I mean, didn't seem that bad.
Look at this timing by Tactical. I think that should be commended a lot.
Oh, yeah, wait, he still got the E on the W?
Yeah.
Yeah. Damn. It wasn't as perfect as I thought, but it was...
Yeah, it was pretty good, for sure. Actually, waiting for it.
Dude, look at that damage. 6k. That was literally a fucking...
Yeah.
Actual one-man show.
1v20. Uh-oh. Ooh, Tactical's fucking dead.
Yeah. That's what should have happened to him so many times.
Yeah, TL actually has, like, zero...
Alfari has no flash. I think he's in big... He's... Everyone's gonna get fucking cleaned. Jensen needs a carry again.
He won't be able to here.
Yeah, I think you just need to get out.
Oh my god.
I don't think you can 1v5 this one.
It feels like C9 is just face rolling TL in teamfights, but like that's not even really how the comp should work.
Yeah,
it's because the start of the fight
is
always so good for them.
C9 has such a fucking strong comp, honestly. Like,
yeah,
I like how they have so many threats with the TF. Like sometimes when you're in TF, especially with this kind of build, you don't have threats, but like Camille, Xin Zhao, and Aphelios are all incredibly strong in teamfighting and scale well.
Yeah.
Yeah. The timing on this Baron is so amazing.
Oh,
it doesn't kill though. That sucks.
That's
and Perks is just gonna be here for the drag fight. barely in time, but he can be there. Or maybe, oh wow, I think C9 is okay with giving this. They're gonna bait TL to, you know, get set up around Dragon, they're not even gonna show up.
I don't mind that.
Like they stood him up on the gate.
Because if you know you're down in tempo against this kind of poke comp, like, yeah, you don't need to force the issue.
No, yeah, I agree. What they're doing here is they are essentially making TL waste time. And they're gonna get a big gold lead on top side.
Yeah, they'll get the head big setup.
Yeah. This is so bad for TL. They need to go back to inhib now. Tier 2 is gone. You need to throw that away. Like, just go inhib. Hello? Sven, hit the fucking turret. Okay. Thank God.
Damn. Might be a little ahead of you. What's your time now?
I'm at 27.
I'll pause at 30.
Okay, 30. 29, 30.
Okay. Sven's got the fucking 3-item spike. Who can even kill him on the team? Unless Jensen does some hero play shit.
Dream is like buffered.
Yeah, I just buffered.
I'm at 40, so we're probably together. The result of that whole macro play by C9 is that they get 3 turrets and all of top jungle. And their bot jungle is still up. So it's a big gold swing for them.
Yep, that was great play by C9 there.
So much autoing. Yeah. Dactyl's build, man. Like, why are you going Frozen Heart against Camille? She does true damage.
True. Damage.
You don't even need armor against Xin Zhao. Is Xin Zhao ever going to hit you? I don't know.
Is Ezreal even, like, strong these days?
No. Not really.
Seems strange that Trey only picked Ezreal.
I think he's playable, but not good. And I think people just default to Frozen Heart third because, I don't know, something is mind controlling people to think that that's good.
Like, oh, but the mana with mana immune, it's just the synergy.
I think especially when you're losing, it's really bad. When you're losing, a lot of the time, what stops you from coming back is you don't do enough damage. So I think you should be okay with, like, oh my god, that was one flamethrower auto, 700 damage.
Yeah, he's still getting junky even with the armor.
Yeah.
Through the glacial shroud?
Even through the glacial shroud? Oh my god.
And it ain't gonna get any better.
Yeah, I mean, Sven has a really god-tier build right now, and he's going straight into GA, which is exactly what you want to see. This is the luxury of winning. When you're winning, you have the luxury of building defensive items. When you're losing, I think you will never come back if you build, like, a post.
Exactly. Did he use up his whole purple gun?
Wait, he just bought a QSS, too.
Yeah.
Ezreal.
Oh, I hate this TP by perks. I hate it.
Oh! Oh! The snipe!
Absolutely massive coming in. With the damage.
I think what Prix is doing here is really nothing. Because, like, he did it too late, where at this point, TL doesn't even care that he's top. I mean, maybe they do have to respond with Jensen's TP, but
they'll have to at least send someone up there.
It's such a huge tool to have or to not have TF ulti. Even just repositioning after the start of the fight, or, like, getting vision of all five. Him not having it here is pretty sad, but lucky for him, TL just gives drag, so.
Yeah, they had to fix top.
Yes.
Yeah, the wave was broke. Nothing they could do.
So smart of Perks to just absolutely dismantle the wave. Reparations were needed.
Had to hire the repairman Jensen to come in.
Yep.
The technician.
But it wasn't that hard, like, you know, it's just like another problem to solve with your gearing, but it's not like the end-all be-all.
Apparently it's in Burning Crusade as well.
Oh, I see. Yeah, I never played BC, so I don't know.
Oh shit, big Baron contest.
Oh my god.
TL's just full group. Oh, I don't know, C9's position isn't that insane here.
Dude, look at Perks. The flank TF is always fucking insane.
Oh wow, it's holy moly.
And that's a fucking wrap. Penta, give Penta.
Oh, he's got
Penta,
it.
Give Penta. Block him.
They played for the Penta.
Come on. Wait, hit the minion. Jensen. Yes!
Oh,
nice.
Oh!
This is the homie.
Oh my god.
Wait, if Blabber knocks him up there, does he die?
Maybe.
To Blabber's third auto?
Pretty close, at least.
Damn, dude. C9 coming out swinging. That was such a fucking strong comp. And even though, like, a lot of their early plays got countered really well by Liquid, still just so hard for Liquid to actually play.
I think when you're playing a poke comp like Ezreal, Azir, Jace, the last thing you want to see on the mid team is so much hard engage. TF Camille Xin Zhao is so hard to kite. But, like, I think that's, we're just slightly biased because we saw them get steamrolled. But, like, in another universe, TL just gets good disengages and, like, kites them out and just plays with range.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, Jensen's it's tough,
dude. Like, you have to fucking... Rapid fire TF is the most obnoxious thing.
Their CC is so off the charts, man. Like, it's
so
unplayable.
I think the way that Perks plays... Yeah, their CC is insane, but I love, like... He starts the fight off in the front, and he gold cards the closest target with rapid fire, and then he just ports in and gets another one.
And then
like,
hits
instantly.
It from the back.
Hits it from the
back. Let's see, with this. Yeah, that auto 100% would have killed.
Oh, I see.
Get
that,
that
minion.
Minion. Yeah.
Look at that minion.
Thank
right
you,
there.
Minion, dude.
That minion.
Yo. Boom.
Minion,
what
bro.
What a satisfying way to get a penta.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was cool.
Dude, they're actually just drafting C9's exact comp. That's
legit.
Fucking hilarious.
Legit.
That's so
I
funny.
Think that I think that C9 and EG must have scrimmed since they're both top teams. And Sven said that EG is going to be really good in playoffs, which means he's probably scrimmed against them recently. So this little meta that developed between them makes sense.
Wukong.
Whoa.
Yep, there you go. Any top laner that can go in with TF, it's great.
I don't know if Wukong has the kill setup that some others might... Seems okay, but
I think at least as like a positive with Wukong is he has an easier time getting the wave in for the dive. He definitely doesn't have the same kill setup,
Manny.
But like,
come on,
Camille Manny. Has a kill setup, but he couldn't get the wave in for four-mans or dives.
Uh huh.
It's actually so funny how exactly like almost exactly the same. You see, Camille and Wukong instead of Camille, and on this side you have instead of Ezreal you have Pokeberries. And instead of Thresh, I mean, the only difference actually for 100 Thieves versus TL is bot lane. Last time it was Ezreal Leona, so it's like 7 out of 10 exact same champs.
Yeah, it's kind of crazy.
Yeah. It's actually the exact same comp except for 3 champs.
Whoa.
That's actually crazy.
3?
Yeah.
Fuck yourself, Meteos.
Oh!
Fuck myself, Meteos. Okay.
Is
I'll be right
a...
back, guys. I gotta go fuck myself. I mean, fairly solid early game. I don't know how this top matchup is supposed
look
to
at,
go early. I feel like Jason normally has
wait.
More,
wait, what
more
the
advantage
fuck?
Early than this.
The ACS? Yeah.
Oh, wait.
I'm not what? A huge fan of Fasting Aphelios, but maybe they'll pull it off.
Uh-oh.
What the fuck?
Dude, if they dive on this big wave stack?
Yes.
That's so
I would,
devastating.
I think they totally should. You don't even need to commit for it, right? Like, the whole point of the dive is to get advantages off this massive wave. If you can kill them, great. If you can make Jizuke use his TF port, or if you can make, Xin Zhao cover it by, like, fucking up his pathing, you should do that. Right
what
here, I would love
doing?
To see Ryoma just walk bot. There is literally 20 creeps bot lane, and Xin is on top side.
I think
come
Jace
on.
Can use his TP advantage as well.
Yeah. Oh, come on, Ryoma, man. Like, this is such a good play to go for, but...
It would be such a poggers.
God, Danny's playing, like, garbage.
He's still kind of got not even all the creeps there. Because he's getting pressured.
Yeah. Yeah, he got 7 creeps on that big wave. Not a good look. There was definitely
like
more than 10 there.
Gap.
Yeah, Luger is impressing us. Who gang?
Well, that's both of them.
Yeah. Yeah, that's true. It's both.
Poom's been hitting a lot of hooks.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
What do you even do if you're EG in this position? This is starting to look like just a fucking unplayable lane. I mean, maybe not starting to, but. You're going to start getting too much gold and XP behind. You won't be able to lane.
I mean, if they're not still getting
just
zoned,
wait
it's fine.
Vamp. Yeah, just wait for Vamp. The 30 CS lead is not going to matter in 10 minutes, so.
Yeah, I think it's kind of like it. The leads already happen, and it won't keep extending.
It's Tommy time.
The only way that you can extend the lead is what we were talking about, where when 100 Thieves builds a wave, the team plays around that to try to grow. But yeah, it's, I don't think 100 Thieves is coordinated enough to pull that off. Not their academy team, at least. I swear their main team would have went for it, though.
Yeah.
Hard to say, but yeah. We haven't seen a massive lead like this in a while.
Yeah, that's...
for bot lane, at least.
Are you guys going to play Tribes of Midgard? That's what my chat said.
Oh.
Yeah, I tried it last night for the first time.
Is it good?
It seems pretty interesting.
Uh-oh.
I didn't really like, play enough to get super into it. Like, it's one of those games where I feel like you have to learn a lot of shit about it. Like, there's kind of like knowledge overwhelming.
Oh, so it's not that fun to be start with? Close.
It's not bad, just I think it'd be more fun once I like know what the fuck I'm doing.
Uh-oh.
Oh my god.
Damn.
I just kind of want to point out that Poom fucked that up so hard by greeting Flash and then flaying. He like flayed Contracts into the turret, but he also like made it impossible for him to flash because then Contracts is behind him. So even if he does flash, he just dies anyways.
Yeah.
That was a bit of a free kill.
God.
Holy shit.
Whoa. Ryoma had blood in his eyes, but it's so bad.
Oh my god.
I mean, they get one back, but...
Yeah, they do.
He just
that
died.
Was an optimistic play.
Ryoma definitely practiced that in practice tool. Like most Azir players know about this, where you can shuffle on. It's mirrored for bot lane as well. You can do the same thing bot lane. He like practiced it. And he's like, finally my fucking time to shine, guys! I practiced so much. I'm gonna make a super play. Dies instantly.
Yeah, that's definitely like one habit of Ryoma that's like not the best is he like will overplay things quite a bit.
Yeah, he's like, oh my god, guys, I've seen this before. Like, I swear Power of Evil did this like 3 weeks ago.
That was a pretty fucking long shuffle.
Yeah.
I didn't realize he started in River for that.
Yeah, it's a cool angle for sure from River to in lane.
It works bot as well. I saw PoE do it.
Yeah, just in that situation, it's so much better if you're Azir to just like hit mid, right? Like, you get the Herald if you can chunk two plates mid there. You can just break it with Herald pretty easily, and then that makes the game way harder for them.
EG has like so much to lose if they lose this game, because it just makes them look like shit.
Mm-hmm. Uh-oh.
Luger has flash. The gold card should have probably connected on Luger instead, but understand why, because he's cleansed, you don't want to go for it. He was kill thresh though. Whew. Spicy game.
Uh-oh. Poom is deep. Not dying, though. Holy shit, Kenby went in?
Yeah, I think Kenby just...
Oh my
gonna
god.
Die
Ryoma! Oh my god, that's so sad! God.
Tragic.
Oh,
why does
no.
Ryoma keep going melee?
That's
Holy
fucked
moly.
Up.
You know, even if Ryoma gets that kill, I think that was a really shit play.
I think Kenvy should not have tried to go in there. Like, that was...
Yeah.
He was hoping to get the kill and then get the reset, but he just didn't have the damage, and it wasn't that close.
Yeah. Sneaky, what do you think about Lethal Tempo of Felios here? I think Lethal Tempo is a great keystone, but not this game when there's no frontline on the enemy team.
Really
interesting.
You think tempo's better
against
tanky?
Tanks. Yeah.
Because
you're putting out more overall DPS, but like Conker is better in the like scrap.
Yeah, I don't know, honestly. Like, I've been so back and forth with trying runes on FLAS. Like, it's so hard to tell like what's better all the time.
Yeah,
because
tempo is
definitely better laning.
Squishy champs is actually press the attack, because you don't need that much uptime to proc it, and it does like flat damage, which is good against squishies. But Press attack always feels kind of awkward.
Yeah.
I don't know why.
Oh my.
Oh my god, ow. Impact.
Jesus.
I think I'm ahead of you guys. I'll pause at 20. At least your first one.
Yeah.
The way Luger plays, it feels like he's never had a Lantern Ward. Oh.
Ooh.
Boom is hitting some nutty hooks, but I mean, it doesn't really seem to matter here at all. But
guess he's just dead.
I'm getting flashbacks to Destiny's Blitzcrank, where he just like hits crazy hooks, loses instantly after. Oh, Jesus.
Oh, ooh. Nice move by Kenvy.
Wait, can they go more? Oh, wow, that missed. He actually had to flash in.
Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah, he could have.
It looked like it would hit, though.
It looked like it would hit. I like the attempt by Ryoma there. It was close. What sucks for him is that he walks down. TF doesn't even have to look bot. He doesn't have to TP. He doesn't have to use his port.
Mm-hmm.
And Jizuke is just like fucking getting super far ahead while conserving both globals. So the next round... Sure, 100 Thieves gets dragged, but like the next round is going to suck for 100 Thieves.
Yeah, I think that's actually one of the signs of like a really good team / player is when you know not to commit to a play. And it's kind of a weakness of Ryoma that I've noticed is like he wants to be the team player, like help out his team. And sometimes people do feel guilty, like your team's getting butt blasted by your counterpart and you're just in your lane. But yeah. I actually think that's the right play a lot of the time.
Mm-hmm.
It's like Jizuke has TP, he could show
Envy
up to
has
fight.
Ult here. That's is that not gonna kill Danny?
I don't think so.
He might have had the shield up. Okay. Shield bow.
He does have shield. Okay. Ends up being fine. One for one trade. If I think Ryoma should next time just be okay with trading his flashes for two flashes. This is, I know that was like obviously like perfect hindsight to say, but
it looks good to double like to flash in there.
Yeah, he might exactly. Because the worst flash. Case that happens. The absolute worst case is they both flash.
Yeah.
But in the best case, you're going to either kill one, kill both, or even, like, scoop their flash and still catch them. That would be, like, super lucky, but there's no reason that you wouldn't flash there. This is what I'm talking about. The next round is so fucking bad.
Oh.
This is so bad for EG.
Oh, God.
Yo, Jizuke? Huh. Oh, my God.
What happened?
He's playing like a monster right now.
He missed his first wild card and then pulls a blue card.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, shit. I thought he was playing well because he gold carded, finished turret, and then Everfrosted. He was doing a lot of high APM shit. I didn't even see the blue card.
He just whips out the first card. Blue.
He just needed the mana.
This is kind of what you mean, though, when you're saying that like the lead's not going to grow. Because it's been 30 CS from AD carries since that point. And I think it's all just comes down to the fact that Aphelios just tends to go shield bow nowadays. And it just makes laning impossible.
I think the gank kind of bailed him out because he did get a kill there.
Yeah.
Like he got the kill on Thresh.
Boom is just hinting. Like,
he's dead.
This is going to kill Ryoma too. Impact's on a great flank.
Oh.
Yeah, I think this might be lights out for the 100 gamers.
Yep.
I think it's kind of hilarious.
No, I think it's winnable.
It's funny that, like, we just saw a game like this and it looked so fucking unplayable for the red side. And then 100 Thieves is like, yeah, we want to do that same thing. That looks good.
Yeah, I don't know how this happened, actually. Such similar comps.
Two games in a row.
Yep. Wait, so the ocean bushes are bugged again.
Yeah, they're kind of right. Like
well,
half
we had a good run.
Yeah, one
we
game.
We were fixed for a minute. All right, Kenvy, do it. Get the steal.
Maybe.
No balls.
Maybe. Oh!
Good try.
Gets out
good
the lantern.
Out, though. As far as like Poom's like lanterns and hooks, they're great. His positioning is probably the weakest point. He's definitely playing like he has Aftershock, and he's also probably playing a different champion, but overall, I'm pretty fine with the way he's played.
You think Ryoma's playing like Aftershock Azir?
Yeah, real misplay after shark is Emax Azir. Is that what we're talking about? Yeah, Ryoma's been really disappointing. What about 100 Thieves top lane? I haven't really had an opinion on him
smacked.
Yet.
Oh my god, does he win?
The red card. Has not been having a good game.
Maybe he needs some tenacity to what not die TF. And he's gone.
Got him. I think 100 Thieves Academy's bot lane did really well this game. Like, they created a huge lead early, and like they ended up throwing it a bit. But I think their team could have capitalized on it way more. Like, Tenacity got TP advantage. Ryoma had push, move timer. Kenvy was there on Dragon.
Yeah.
But they just weren't able to make it happen.
Yeah, exactly. Like, I think a better team, instead of doing drag there, is very deep in enemy red jungle. You know, being a human ward and also, like, clearing whatever camps are there and getting ready for the dive. Like, Dragon, I think dragons should be an afterthought when there's nothing to do. Like, as in, like, there's not a lot of your jungle to farm. There's no dives to go for. I don't think that, like, you should give up a play to get dragon.
Oh.
Yeah, I completely agree. Like, when they're missing sums pushed in low HP, there's no reason to go for dragon there.
Yeah.
Yeah, that would have been a massive snowball.
Yeah, for sure.
And oh?
Oh my god.
Really, really unkillable Braum.
He hits a TP, he doesn't do anything, he has no ult. And no flash.
I'm starting to think that Braum is just really fucking good against a full poke comp. Like,
hell yeah.
He's just not taking. He is just.
Yeah, Jace can't do anything to him.
They can't even shoot him.
The most damage ever. What are you guys saying? Braum is fucking garbage against poke.
Wait,
Braum's good if your team has a way of starting the fight that's not like Braum, you know?
Oh shit, is he dying? Oh!
Contracts?
Oh my god!
Holy fuck, Contracts is a goddamn man.
He literally can't die.
Isn't Jao balanced?
I don't think so.
He's just casually 1v3ing them.
Dude, I think if you weren't watching this game super closely, you would have missed that there was a little bit of a mid gap.
Oh my god, that ult missed. Ow. Oh! Wait. Is Contracts the unkillable? Killable?
Oh my god, Contracts doing such a good job avoiding all this damage.
Oh!
Oh my god, he didn't do his third auto.
Okay, pick one guy that you think is gonna die.
Boom.
Oh. Nope.
Boom!
Really?
He's unkillable.
No,
are you kidding me?
You actually can't
but
touch him.
They stopped fucking hitting him.
Wait, it's
he
actually
was
a turn.
HP. Where was it?
Impact got fucking hooked in the fountain.
Fountain plus ratio.
Oh!
Uh-oh.
Wait.
Oh!
Wait.
It's insane.
EG throwing plus ratio?
Yes, absolutely.
Luger with a triple, 5-0-2, Elo Hell.
Actually winnable. I agree.
Danny is so allergic to building IE, it's fucking hilarious.
Wait, he doesn't have an IE? Uh-oh. Oh, he's fucking
what
dead.
What the hell?
Okay, wait, they just lost. Oh my god, TF damage.
Dude, I think they would have won this fight if Danny had IE. Oh, Jizuke!
another fountain dive.
Stop throwing in the fountain, you fucking animals.
Wait, did Luger die this game? He didn't. 6-0. Loss.
Unkillable.
Perfect KDA.
The whole point of that match right there was to hike up Luger's stocks so that a team would buy him next split.
Actually, probably true.
Yeah.
Just Luger? Or
just Luger. They're like, we gotta fucking show this guy off so we can sell him for big bucks. Alright guys. We gotta look at the draft. CLG is playing a really fucking aggressive early comp. Wow. That's a lot of click stuns. I kinda like that Broxah wasted his entire solo queue this year playing Elise, and now he can finally play it on stage in the game that doesn't matter. At least we get to see it. I think with Leo and Renekton, Elise is way stronger of a pick because you have that crazy dive pressure on both top and bot. I think typically people think that like Elise is like the shittiest at ganking mid. The angles are like a lot more awkward, and the dive potential mid is definitely lower than side. But yeah, I think CLG is kind of going.
Broxah picked Elise for me.
Hello.
Dude, Meteos, like, can you believe that Broxah wasted like 300 games this split playing useless ass champions like fucking Elise, Lilia, and Karthus, and now he's finally playing it in the game that doesn't matter.
Dude,
practice for this one.
I'm so surprised about like how underrepresented Elise has been. Like, I can see why she's not like the best champ, but this is literally like the first time she's been picked in LCS all year, isn't it?
I'm not surprised. Elise can't farm. I don't think that's surprising at all.
She's so broken.
Every time I play against Elise, my jungler just says, just don't die to her for the first 5 minutes, and she can't farm her jungle. And like, she just fall behind super hard. She's gonna look for cheese ganks and dives.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I mean, she's definitely not like the fastest farmer, but to say she can't farm is kind of also an overstatement, because like, with Sorc Boots, it's like a decent spike for her farming, because she's just true damage.
Yeah.
You're right, Meteos.
Aw.
It's the best.
I want you to know that your feelings are heard. And I'm here if you need me.
I'm here if you need me. Man, is FlyQuest not running just like the biggest fucking trap comp of all time?
Maybe.
Broxah has no flash.
I thought it was C9 that had the biggest trap comp.
No, it was
because of Sneaky.
Oh my goodness. Flushed. Wait, so I was curious about the standings. So like, if Fly wins this game, they're in playoffs. But if they lose, they're not.
I believe so, yeah. Ooh, and there it is.
Damn.
The dive.
The Golden Guardians icon getting massive spammed.
Dude,
now that
the standings literally don't matter, I have literally never seen Broxah play this aggressive in my life.
Oh my god, he dies!
Tragedy. Did Broxah not just spend the last, like, fucking 5 minutes patrolling the enemy half of the map?
He really did.
Yeah.
Like, I've never seen him play like this. I've always said that Broxah is the kind of guy who will feel really bad doing any sort of vertical jungling, and he's not the kind of guy to just, like, force the issue into the enemy topside or enemy botside jungle. Like, he'll always back off and just go back to his side of the map.
Yeah.
And now it's like completely the opposite. He just left bot lane out to dry and has just been topside for the last like fucking 7 minutes straight.
Yeah,
and it's been good. It's been really good.
Like, that's how you have to play, because I was actually watching Broxah's stream like sometime last week just to like, you know, maybe get an idea of his thought process and stuff. And like, while it was solo queue, like, a lot of what he was saying was like, it seemed like the thing that got his attention the most is, like, if one of his teammates was doing bad, he wants to, like, try to help them out. Like, oh, I need to, like, help this lane get back to the game. And
yeah.
I feel like that's usually not the best way to go about things. Usually in solo queue, I think just, like, prioritizing getting yourself ahead and snowballing your winning lanes is, like, usually going to get you better mileage than trying to get a losing lane back into the game.
Yeah. Just a fucking casual 3v4 topside.
That looked weird.
Almost dead. This is so bad for FlyQuest.
Why are they countering this, dude? Can't you like go dive Ezreal or something more useful?
This is really reminding me of the last time that Kumo was getting permadove. Is like maybe just part of part of having him be like the main shot caller that they're talking about is like he's dragging people to just a horrible play. This happened with Alfari too, when Alfari was playing shit, what was he playing? Camille? I forgot. But Kumo was just getting like perma zoned off his turret. Oh. Yeah, it was Camille with Ignite.
Yeah.
And like the team is, if you look at the situation, just eye test. Do quick fucking quick maths, guys. 3v4. How are you gonna get on your turret? You're not. So get run. Give it.
They have really good dive too.
Yeah, yeah. It's Elise, Leona, Renekton. I can't think of a better fucking early game comp than this.
I honestly don't think that situation ever goes well for FlyQuest unless CLG plays it absolutely horribly.
Yeah.
Because, like, they're always going to walk behind the tower to make sure FlyQuest isn't sitting right there like they did. And then they'll either fight him if they're behind the tower. If all of FlyQuest's three man's under the tower, you can just leave and go make a play mid or something. And you're going to have Giga Tempo because they're, like, stuck under tower and then have to walk into a blind jungle where you could be camping. It's just, It never goes well for them, honestly. I don't like seeing this kind of play.
Wait, Ezreal rushed Manimmune. That's pretty cringe. Wait, why would he do that?
Probably based on the perfect money after starting gear.
It's so bad. It's like so much worse than the previous version of Manimmune. Like, you kind of had to rush the other Manimmune. But now that, like, you don't stack it as much, it doesn't actually do anything to rush it.
Wow. Diamond had a kill opportunity, and he just didn't believe in himself. Like, he W ignites their turtle dies, but I totally understand why he didn't do it. It's just off the cuff. Very unexpected. But back to what you're saying, I don't think... I don't know the exact...
It's pretty bad.
...of Manimmune Rush. It's really bad.
And... I mean, like, you get... You don't even really get it to stack faster, and you're just going to get more bang for your buck paying for other things.
Oh shit. Oh, there it is.
Great play by FlyQuest. Oh, jeez. That was sick.
Now CLG are the ones defending.
The greatest part about playing it with Rell is sometimes what happened there is, like, Rell gets the engage and the AD carry flashes out, but it's not enough. If you don't flash, like, instantly, if there's, like, a lot of angles where Rell, like, you'll flash and it'll still suck you back in, so you basically just flash for nothing.
Wait, the turret just died. And Finn didn't get the plates. Or the local.
Wait, no.
The fuck?
I don't believe that.
Yeah, dude, look where he was. They had the little cam showing the turret getting beaten by minions.
Wait. That's disgusting.
Finn? Bruh?
Why'd he just lose like 400 something gold? For fun?
Oh my god.
God, dude. Nah, that one's bad as fuck. There's like zero justification for that other than you're just bad.
Yeah, dude, I don't know.
Are you guys, who, Finn?
Yeah, Finn.
I think he just made a one-off mistake.
Oh yeah, one-off? Huh.
Yeah.
Yeah, Finn's never made a mistake before. We can give him this one. Unlucky.
Holy shit, man. I can't believe that. I don't know.
It's pretty gross.
Imagine this is the guy you're trying to play around. If I'm Broxa and I see my laner
Smoothie!
Oh shit, there's fucking squads coming?
Yeah.
Hey guys.
Jesus. Tomo died for free. That... Wow. I really gotta commend Tomo for trying that. He tried to counter... He tried to, like, self-peel by ulting went right before he got Leo ulted, but Smoothie flashed over.
Turtle jumped it too, right?
I think it was aimed at Smoothie.
Smoothie's looking like one of the best supports in this game.
Yeah, possibly.
That flash in.
Dude, I'm just saying that Finn is putting on a monster Renekton performance in the game between CLG and FlyQuest.
Could just be the best Renekton I've seen in the last 14 minutes. Wait, let's see it. Did he jump over? Did both of them jump over?
So Tomo thought he could save his flash by ulting to kind of like self-peel.
Yeah, it was kind of
Smoothie,
kinda
right? That way Smoothie doesn't get the perfect chain. Smoothie is...
Dude, I would have loved to see CLG just run through the turret up into the jungle.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Instead of accepting their death. Yeah, that's right. Hard.
But that would have been a good response.
Mm-hmm.
Field bow gravy. Yeah.
I would guess he's making a bit more.
I'm not going to say in it, though, because like, I feel like if you're fucking moving to a different continent, like you would get some kind of compensation for that.
I'm sure you get some say and maybe even a slight monetary reward, but like I think the overwhelming majority of that money went to the orc.
Probably.
Oh my god, Tomo is murdered.
Somebody call an ambulance.
But not for Demonte.
He did it.
Dude, honestly, one of the biggest mistakes I see Echoes make, and I did this shit a ton when I was learning him, but like, you should almost always ult on Echo right away when you get chunked. Because like, sometimes you hold it because you're like, oh, I want to hold it for when I'm going to die, but the problem is like, if you get chunked for half your HP when you go in and you don't ult, like, you're not going to get to go in again. Like, you're not going to just start a fight with half HP.
Yeah.
You just want to ult after you take like the first initial amount of damage so then you can like, at least still be a champion.
Yeah.
Trying to hold your ult too long is Giga Trap.
The only way you'd hold it even slightly is just so you can get like the better position for it to actually hit someone.
Yeah. But like, I watched a lot of VODs from like Echo One Tricks and stuff, and it was super common. They would almost always go for like the one shot and then just ult out.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, that's good. It's also not that long of a cooldown.
Yeah. At level 16, and you can start just spamming it.
It's kind of like Zed. Zed ult's like a 28-second cooldown or some shit. 16.
Yeah.
So stupid.
Zed's such a cool champion. He's like one of the few champs I think we'd benefit a lot in competitive if he was more popular.
Yeah.
It's hard to get him in a spot where he's competitively viable without just being absolute solo queue terrorist.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. That was a weepee by Turtle getting through mid ult.
Yeah, that was a nice ass ult.
I wonder what he's gonna go next. I would like Surreal this.
We always and want then, that, and nobody builds it.
We always want Surreal this, man. Give. And I like Hydra.
That
there goes Kumo.
That really big ASCI Hydra?
Huh?
Dude, that Hydra's heads look a little weird.
Hands up. Hands up.
Game over. CLG manages, despite their best efforts, to control one objective this game. Woohoo!
CLG, I guess, actually going to get a win.
They do have a chance of winning on the next dragon if CLG shits their pants, which they're really good at doing. But like, if CLG just plays even 1% human, they can go 99% gorilla, but 1% human is enough to win.
Wait, Turtle building for real? Oh my god.
He didn't go Frozen Heart or some random bullshit items?
Wait, he got Tiamat.
Who is this man?
Well, yeah, I really think Hydra is really OP on Ezreal. Like, I think this is the build.
Yeah, Hydra's good as fuck. Surreal's good as fuck.
All these items are so good. You could replace Sunder with, like, a Essence Reaver, but then he wouldn't have a mythic item, so I kind of like the Sunder.
I want to see him switch the Sunder for Frostfire Gauntlet. And the Cerildas for Frozen Heart, and then I like it.
Hmm.
Okay.
Thoughts?
So he can tank skill shots?
Yeah. Yeah.
That does make sense. God, Ezreal feels so good to play at this point. Like, clearing waves feels good. Like, team fighting feels fucking good. I think he doesn't have any sustain yet, but when he finally finishes Ravenous, it's just like...
Especially when so he rubs his nipples as Ezreal at this point. It feels so good.
I think Ezreal should start rushing Ravenous Hydra. I think that's going to be the next generation of Ezreal builds.
Rushes it?
Yeah, like first item Ravenous Hydra.
Mm.
Oh, dude, Insanity's in my chat? Yeah, that's the same idea I had. He said, first item Ravenous for the ult one-shot wave clear.
Yeah.
I was wondering if that, if it always works out like that.
No, we asked about it, remember? It's like, you can only take damage from one.
Yeah, I know you only take damage from one, but, like, does it make... Is that one enough that it just clears?
Mm.
All right, it's LCS, guys. Got 10 people alive. Let's start Baron. Oh, let's get off after getting everyone.
Oh, let's get off. Let's trunk ourselves. What the? Go into a horrible fight.
What just happened to Smoothie's HP?
Oh, my.
Wait. Holy shit. This is awkward for CLG.
Of course, CLG found the only way that you could ever lose this fight.
Kumo, no.
Did Kumo not take the Leona body?
Oh, no, he did.
He did? Okay.
He just couldn't do anything in it.
He tried to burst Samantha on Insomnia.
Okay.
I think.
How?
Let's see. Maybe I'm smoking.
Can people still make this mistake? 10 people alive. Start Baron.
Fuck it, dude. Let's just Baron.
Is there really no, like, buddy on this team with a fucking brain?
Wait.
Can you just play the game normally?
Murdered randomly.
Yeah, he did.
Yeah, he took a fat one.
Oh, wait, no. Wait, did he have... I don't think he got the assist,
he took
Elise's
body right here.
Did he get the assist on Leona?
Then he repels him to die.
Yeah, I don't think he got the Leona body.
Yeah. I guess I'm smoking.
I feel like a broken record anyway. I'm gonna get... It's so crazy. It's so crazy.
What's crazy?
You have the game completely won if you just push them into the base and then start Baron, but they just walk up halfway to the recall... Everyone walks river, they put down their wards, they're like, yeah, it looks good, let's just do it.
Yeah, dude, I don't know. I feel like they just don't understand so many of these teams. I don't get how they don't understand how to get a free Baron.
But you learned this shit in, like, season 3. Like,
okay, I don't remember. Is it
eight years later, yeah, like, actually, it's like, it's Wumbo, Wumbology, the study of Wumbo. Like, it's just so, shit that you learn so early in your career. And CLG is a team of veterans, apparently. I guess.
Oh, it's not even. It's that time again, boys.
People alive, start the Baron. Let's go.
Let's go, Baron Rush.
Right, this one.
Wait, Jose's not gonna get there in time. He has to do the Raptors.
Dude, look at all the blue orbs. Wait a sec. What? Why are there 6 blue orbs on the purple side? What the fuck?
Damn, that was a really nice bait attempt by CLG. Doing it with the Raptors up, they knew Jose had to get the Raptors first.
How are there so many? What?
They just have 5 blue orbs, bro.
I'm so confused.
Look at Turtle's damage, by the way. Oh my god.
Oh, that's GG.
Yeah, okay. But like... He's not really AoE slowing anyone's attack speed with this build, so is it really that efficient?
Those aren't zombie
actually,
wards.
You're right.
Are they? I don't think so.
Like, the other team's just attacking at completely full speed when they're next to him, so... if you're only looking at the massive amount of damage he's doing, that's... You're kind of overlooking
him. He's, like, really close to going right here, so... I think he probably needed that extra frozen heart.
Damn, dude. And CLG advances to the World Finals.
Yeah, so,
absolutely jacked.
So FlyQuest is out of playoffs, right?
Maybe.
And that's Golden Guardians in?
I think so. Maybe. Damn, I do not understand
people who get completely naked when they sleep. Like, I never grew up that way or, like, started doing that, so it just feels uncomfortable. Like, feeling my skin on the covers is like, ugh.
Wait, what do you mean by completely naked? Like,
do you take your shirt off when you sleep?
Sometimes, yeah.
Wait, are you one of those people who keeps their clothes on when you take a dump in a public restroom?
Well, obviously not, dude. I wouldn't want to get poop on my shirt. But, like, face up to the ceiling, so I'm just like fully flat on my back with my shirt on, and my balls hanging out.
Ooh.
Oh,
right
my.
On your face.
Oh my that, word.
That's a good mental picture.
Good
thank
heavens.
You.
All right. Well, it was fun, boys.
Yeah, that was a poggers.
Wish I can say It was a pleasure.
Well, I think it was a pleasure, but all right.
Wish I can say it's been a pleasure.
I wish I could say it wasn't a pleasure, but it was. So thank you guys, and good night.
Yep. Thank you, boys.
Peace.
GG.
See you guys for playoffs.
Yep. See ya. Demonte did them a solid. Yeah, I tweeted this out, but it's pretty